Hello there, this is just a quick video on making 360 degree videos for YouTube with Pinnacle Studio version 22 Ultimate. If you have a version later than 22, this video might not apply to you because it may support direct upload to YouTube. So here I am in Pinnacle Studio, and what I'm going to do is to create a new project from the menu. I'm going to collapse this area here and get some new files to work with. First of all, I'm going to import the video file that I'm talking about. Okay, choosing the right source folder. And I'm going to import both the 360 degree video and a separate audio file that's not really involved in our demonstration today, but I'm going to import them both because I need them for the project I'm doing. Okay, click Start Import here in the lower left. And when we get back to the Edit tab here in the middle, you'll see the files both included. Okay, I'm going to drag the video file to the timeline. And you can see that it's a 360 degree video that was recorded with front and back lenses. There are other geometries for 360 cameras, but today I'm just going to be concentrating on this one because that's the file I need to work with today. I'm actually doing this for real purposes, for a band performance, to which I'm going to add professional audio. And now that Pinnacle Studio is finishing up processing the file, I'm going to start working with it as a 360 degree video. First, let me mute and play the preview a little bit. Okay, that seems to be working just fine. Okay, pause it, go back to the beginning, and we'll change the settings as required for 360 degrees. So you go to the timeline settings, that's these two little gears, bring that up, and in the aspect ratio, you can see one of the choices is 360 video 2:1. You select that. And since the 360 camera needs an awful lot of pixels, we're going to use the highest setting that's available here. And then we click Apply. So the lens on the left here is considered the front lens of the camera. And the default view that we actually want to have in this case is the group's conductor, who is in the right-hand lens. So we would like to have the default view starting being back towards the conductor, so we'll make the adjustments to do that. Okay, so the process of switching front to back lenses, you can do it in a couple of ways, and I'm going to show you the simplest way to just swap them around. Okay, if you go down in the timeline and right click, you can choose 360 video. We're going to select 360 degree video conversion, and there's two lenses on the camera, so we're going to pick double fisheye to equirectangular, and then you see this view. Okay, and when you do that, the editor opens up here in the upper left. If you instead see a library, you can figure out what's going on and pick edit. And you can also pick the double fisheye to equirectangular from here. And then these slider controls in the middle here, you can swap around. You can change the left center Y and the right center Y and just swap their values. And it's not X for whatever reason, it's Y. So you can take this .253 and put it down in the lower box, and take the .748 and put it up into the upper box. And when you do that, it'll have the effect of turning the video around 180 degrees for your starting position. Okay, now I'm going to do some work that involves dropping in an audio track and some titles. So that doesn't have anything to do specifically with creating a 360 degree video. So I'm going to pause the recording while I do that and then continue afterwards. Okay, I've made those changes. I did in fact turn around the lens to face front. So now what we want to do is export the file. So you pick the export option up here on the right of the three controls. And then you have a variety of settings here. I'm going to pick a preset of Quad HD 2560 by 1080 for this. I believe the original was recorded at 1920, but that's okay, just in case we'll export it at the higher resolution. Okay, so up here I'm going to give it a name, indicating that it's the music from Chicago. And then I will click Start Export here. And it's rendering now. Okay, the export is completed, and you might think that we're ready to go to YouTube now, but not quite. There's one more step that's very important. Okay, let's come out to the folder where the export was created. I called it Chicago 360 Candidate 1, which doesn't match the name I typed it before, but don't be put off by that. If you play it with one of the installed Windows players, you can see that if you click down here on 360 video, it appears to be working just fine. However, it's not going to work on YouTube, and the reason is that we need to run a tool that you can get from Google, which is the Spatial Media Metadata Injector. So this rewrites a copy of the file with some more internal information that YouTube needs to properly interpret the 360 video. So like I said, if you upload it to YouTube without running this tool, it's not going to work. Okay, so let's run the tool. We're going to open up the file here, and then we're going to inject metadata. Notice that it clicked the spherical 360 checkbox, which is what we want. So we're going to click to inject the metadata here. And then it's going to suggest a final file name, which is the original file name with underscore injected appended. So we're going to click Save. Now it's doing its thing. And now we can close it, and you'll see that we have a freshly written file, Chicago 360 Candidate 1 underscore injected .mp4, and that's the one we want to upload to YouTube. Okay, first we're going to demonstrate on YouTube the video that wasn't injected with the metadata tool. And you can see that it looks like this, unsuccessful. So let's get a fresh browser tab over here, and now we're going to play the one that has been injected. And you can see that it is a proper 360 degree video. So that's it for the demonstration. Now, I haven't stated exactly where to get the injector tool because it may move, it may become obsolete, there may be a new version, YouTube may not need it, Pinnacle Studio 23 may not need it, I'm not sure yet, I haven't tried it. But for version 22, the demonstration is complete. Thanks for watching and good luck with your products.